So to begin with, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to AIOC and my mentor, Dr. Kasturi Bhattacharji, to have given me this opportunity to share the platform with such distinguished members in the field of oculoplasty. So today I will be briefly talking about the indications of navigation guidance in ophthalmic plastic surgery. As Milind sir very well explained, in literature, the working of navigation system has often been compared to GPS, that is the global positioning system. The image guided systems utilize infrared cameras or electromagnetic fields to capture and relay the patient's anatomy and the surgeon's precise movements in association with the patient to computer screens in the operating room. Navigation guided surgery has widely been used in the field of neurosurgery as well as ENT. In orbitofacial surgery, it has both preoperative and intraoperative applications. So indications of navigation-guided surgeries are as follows. The orbital decompression in thyroid orbitopathy, optic canal decompression in primary and secondary reconstructions associated with orbital fractures and trauma, orbital foreign body removal, orbital tumor resection, reconstruction of anophthalmic socket. To begin with, orbital decompression in thyroid orbitopathy. Navigation guidance in this particular case helps us in exacting bony landmarks for decompression. It helps us to measure the thickness and locate areas of thick bone for drilling. It exacts the endpoint of decompression based on preoperative planning. In cases of deep lateral decompression, superior orbital fissure often marks the endpoint of surgery. Now, in case of orbital fractures, especially the unilateral ones, the navigation system is particularly useful to perform mirroring, which is far more precise than eyeballing the contralateral site for symmetry. Preoperatively, virtual planning and implant insertion can aid in the selection of the correct implant size and its 3D positioning. Navigation-assisted mirroring, measuring, and simulating help predictably restore the orbital anatomy and volume and achieve successful reconstruction. Optic canal decompression in cases of traumatic optic neuropathy has wide application of the navigation guided system. A high resolution CT scan highlighting the optic nerve injury and optic canal fracture is loaded onto the console and a 3D model is obtained. Thereafter, a target is set. Once the target area is reached in the surgery, the navigation stylet can be used to confirm this. So navigation guidance in case of optic canal decompression provides a precise and safe route with accurate target acquisition and minimal complications. In orbital foreign body removal, navigation guidance provides accurate and real-time position of the foreign bodies, minimal collateral damage, the determination of appropriate surgical path, and increased rate of successful foreign body extraction. In cases of orbital tumor resection, the navigation helps to accurately localize the target, establish precise tumor margins, avoid any untoward vascular trauma. In these cases, mirroring can be used to symmetrically reconstruct the residual large bony defects which are left after the tumor resection. Navigation can also be used in the reconstruction of anophthalmic sockets, wherein mirroring helps to determine the amount of volume augmentation needed for bilateral orbital symmetry. Last but not the least, in cases of endoscopic orbital and lacrimal surgeries, real-time CT guidance can be used to identify the lacrimal sac and its relation to the surrounding structures. It also provides an appropriate radiological landmark. These are my references. Thank you so much.